बिफोर आई गेट स्टार्टेड, दो वीडियोस बनाने के बाद मुझे अक्कल आ गई है कि वीडियो की स्टार्टिंग में सब्सक्राइब करने के लिए डिमांड रखनी चाहिए। प्लीज यहाँ क्लिक करें। नमस्ते, मैं सोचा रहा था अपनी इंट्रोडक्शन आप कमेंट सेक्शन में दे दीजिए प्लीज। हर रोज दिमागी हालत थोड़ी वल्नरेबल ज्यादा होती चली जा रही है आजकल। ऐसे में कुछ फिल्में ऐसी हैं ऑनलाइन जिन्हें देखकर आई फील वेरी मच सुकून। तो आई मेड अ लिस्ट ऑफ द टॉप 10 हैप्पीएस्ट फिल्म्स ऑन द इंटरनेट राइट नाउ, ऑल ऑफ देम रेकमेंडेड बाय यू, जिसमें से इस वीडियो में मैं शेयर करूंगी 5, अगले वीडियो में 5 और। आ जाओ। नंबर 5 पर है मामा मिया, जिसे आप देख सकते हैं यूट्यूब पर। फरमाइश आई है Niels.Niels की ऑन इंस्टाग्राम, Delecta_Fernand ऑन ट्विटर। इफ देयर वाज एवर अ मूवी मेड जिसकी वन लाइन डिस्क्रिप्शन है जस्ट मेक मी फ्रिकिंग हैप्पी, इट्स मामा मिया। एक तो ऐबा के सदाबहार गीत जो कैरियोकी बार्स में अगर गाए नहीं है आपने तो दोस्तों को सुन सुनकर लिरिक्स सारे याद है ना। ऊपर से मेरिल स्ट्रीप वेयरिंग डेनिम ओवरऑल्स डांसिंग अराउंड विद हर गर्लफ्रेंड्स ऑन एन आइलैंड जहां जैसे उनका राज चल रहा है। इट्स आल्सो सो लिबरेटिंग ना दैट हियर्स दिस वुमन हु हैड अफेयर्स विद 3 मेन एंड इट डजंट रियली बॉदर हर हु द फादर ऑफ हर चाइल्ड माइट बी, क्योंकि शी इज हैप्पी विद हर डॉटर एंड हर पैल्स बिकॉज लाइफ में उसको और कुछ चाहिए नहीं।
एवरी फैमिली
आई रेड मॉम्स डायरी
has a secret
and I have 3 possible fathers
but when the men do appear on the island no one is complaining kyunki it is Pierce Brosnan, Colin Firth, Stellan Skarsgård, ek se ek badhkar sundar aadmi. The story could have been set in Manhattan or LA and the characters would have still remained the same but the movie written and directed by women wants to take you away on an island where reality is not reality and all the ladies are allowed to make up their own rules, live by their own laws. It's the perfect kind of escapism for most of us right now locked in our apartment. तो देखो, there is already a lot of conversations around Mamma Mia on the internet and why it's one of the happiest films ever made. I won't add to that noise, पर आप 120 रुपए देकर YouTube पर इसे रेंट कर लो, सब परिवार मजे ही मजे। Favorite scene, Pierce Brosnan का तभी 2-1 साल पहले James Bond करियर खत्म हुआ था and एकदम से to see him singing SOS was such a wonderful surprise.
So when you're near me, darling, can't you hear me? SOS.
I remember the moment when I first realized ki this was happening and he was actually singing. Aur kya khushi mehsoos hui thi us moment mein. Number 4, Tere Bin Laden. Ise aap dekh sakte hain Daily Motion par, Pen Movies ka official channel. Iski farmaish kisi ne nahi kari hai, to ye meri submission hai to this list. Clever movies make me happy. On paper, Tere Bin Laden's premise is ridiculous. A journalist who pretends to interview Osama Bin Laden because he desperately wants to immigrate from Pakistan and only an explosive story like this, pun not intended, can make that happen.
प्लीज मूड बना, कैरेक्टर में आके प्रॉपरली कर। हाँ प्लीज, शाबाश, तू कर लेगा, मुझे पता तेरा।
यूजुअली आई एम क्वाइट वेरी ऑफ हिंदी फिल्म्स जिनका टाइटल इज अ पन ऑन द मूवीज थीम और द कैरेक्टर्स नेम या कॉन्सेप्ट, जो भी करवा लो, मस्ती ज्यादे, उजड़ा चमन, बट दिस वन डजंट फेल ऑन दैट काउंट। Ali Zafar in his first outing in Bollywood plays the lead, the aforementioned journalist who just wants to go to America and the whole movie is kahin ki it kahin ka roda because the kind of ridiculous people he manages to bring together to make this harebrained scheme come true is most of the meat of the film and really the true win of writer-director Abhishek Sharma. The star of the movie though is Pradyuman Singh who looks like Osama. His take on the language, mannerisms, they steal the scene in every frame. When you're writing stories which are so ridiculous, there's always a fear of crossing over into the houseful territory where it isn't slapstick comedy anymore, it's just brainless tripe which barely qualifies as storytelling. Lekin Tere Bin Laden expertly balances theater of the absurd hand in hand with storytelling rules and stays true to the universe it creates.
The aftermath of Bin Laden's new tape has been horrific for all of America.
And astute commentary on the randomness of the American visa process combined with the country's desperation to capture Osama Bin Laden and retain the world leader position. And to develop compelling comedy making fun of such a terrifying figure as Osama is not an easy task. It's political satire crafted with a lot of subtext. And if you haven't watched it since it first released, Tere Bin Laden must be revisited.
Jaldi kar, on air jana hai.
Favorite favorite scene. Piyush Mishra is the owner of Danka TV. One day, while out veggie shopping with his perennially angry wife, played by Seema Pava, he gets kidnapped by Americans and Pakistani security and interrogated inside a sewer. The agents are asking him about Osama while eating the carrots he had just purchased with his wife. It's funny because it's aware how silly it is. Number 1 par is list mein ek Malayali film hai. Kaun si? Janne ke liye dekhte rahiye. Lekin idhar subscribe kar lijiye pehle please. Thanks. Number 3, Harish Chandrachi Factory on Netflix. Farmaish aayi hai @rockmax_ on Twitter. सबसे पहले तो ख्याल आएगा कि आज तक कैसे किसी ने दादा साहब फाड़के पर बायोपिक नहीं बनाया.
आई एम धुंडीराज गोविंद फाड़के फ्रॉम इंडिया. आई वॉन्ट टू मेक अ मोशन पिक्चर. कैन यू हेल्प?
It's a fascinating story of a man with nothing but hope and the kind of madman determination only people with a clear end goal in sight possess. Writer-director Paresh Mukashi takes this huge responsibility onto himself and delivers a rather unexpected happy little film. Set in pre-independence India, Mumbai to be precise, the year is 1911. Protagonist, yani Dhundiraj Phadke, who later came to be known as Dada Saheb, unke sar pe na junoon ek sawar hai ki India ki pehli homemade motion picture banni चाहिए, चाहे पैसे जोड़ने के लिए घर की एक एक चीज बेचनी पड़ जाए. नाउ दिस साउंड्स ब्लीक ना, व्हेन यू सी पीपल ऑब्सेस्ड विद एन आइडिया व्हिच कंज्यूम्स देयर होल लाइफ. लेकिन द ब्यूटी ऑफ हरिश्चंद्राची फैक्ट्री इज दैट अस एज ऑडियंस नेवर फील सैड और इरिटेटेड विद फाड़के एट एनी पॉइंट बिकॉज द फिल्म गोज टू ह्यूज लेंथ्स टू इंश्योर नो रियल कॉन्फ्लिक्ट और हार्डशिप्स और ट्रेजिक मोमेंट्स आर एलैबोरेटेड इन द स्क्रीन प्ले. नो, फट फट बड़े बड़े इश्यूज ऐसे उसकी लाइफ में आते हैं और फट फट फाड़के हंसते हंसते उनको सॉल्व करते चले जाता है और आगे निकल जाता है. When he's penniless in London, he happens to just sit in a restaurant owned by a Marathi, who gives him not just free food, but also a warm scarf and an umbrella. When he temporarily loses his vision due to watching too much cinema, he's cured very sweetly within a few scenes while chilling at home. Add to this, Nandu Mahadev as Phadke. He brings a Charlie Chaplin-esque quality to the character, which is used quite cleverly, because this is a movie about silent era films. So huge chunks of his life and journey, they play out in sped up montage scenes. Sequences without any dialogue. It's both funny and comforting. While Harish Chandrachi Factory is not path-breaking cinema, and honestly, if I had been reviewing it when we were not in lockdown, I might not have been so kind. Lekin, this 2009 Marathi entertaining and historical movie deserves a spot on this list because it's a story of hope, of achievement, and victory against all odds, told with a lot of heart. It's so easy to consume. You can make an evening of it with your family while eating dinner and arguing ki bartan dhone ki aaj kiski baari hai. My favorite scene. When Phadke is first realizing his love for cinema, he takes his whole family to watch shows of silent English films in a tambu. While everybody is looking at the screen, Phadke is sitting cross-legged on the floor, resolutely looking in the other direction at the projection room from where the light is coming. It's funny, but also establishes the curious side of his character in one instant without even showing the expressions on his face. Number 2, The Big Sick. It's on Amazon Prime Video. Farmaish Kusha Kapila on Instagram and Mohar Basu on Twitter. This semi-autobiographical movie, written by Kumail Nanjiani and his wife Emily Gordon, directed by Michael Showalter, put Kumail Nanjiani in the big leagues before he looked like this. I watched this on a flight a few months after it had released, and despite the teeny tiny screen with bad contrast and saturation, 20 minutes into the film and I knew that this is an instant all-time favorite.
I'm guessing it's a young single Pakistani woman.
This is Zubeda. For your files? Your X-Files? That's your favorite show, huh?
It's the story of a Pakistani man who moved to America at a young age with his family and has spent most of his adult life living a dual identity, one Pakistani and one American, forever struggling with which side he lands on when it's time to compare. To make this decision more complicated, he falls in love with a white woman, jiski wajah se his family kind of disowns him and his relationship with the girl almost ends.
I've been dating this girl. She's white.
A white girl?
Hey, you can't look like you and yell white girl.
It's okay. We hate terrorists.
But when she's diagnosed with an illness which almost kills her, it's on him to decide ki abhi uski zarurat kisko hai zyada. Mummy, daddy ya Emily? Because this is semi-autobiographical, Kumail and Emily have imbued so much heart and honesty into this film that despite it not being a comedy and frankly a proper tearjerker, the movie fills you with love and happiness. Two things the human race could do with more of, especially right now.
Oh my god, I'm so stupid.
Can you imagine a world in which we end up together?
I don't know.
The film reminds you of all the moments you've spent hating on your family, but then realizing that you feel so strongly towards them because you love them so much. These feelings of anger aren't hate, they're just that, anger. And it's okay to be mad at the ones you love, because that kind of love permits you to feel those feelings. But this sounds like kabhi khushi kabhi gham. Anywho, the Big Six cast also includes Anupam Kher as Kumail's father, Zoe Kazan as Emily, Ray Romano, Holly Hunter as her parents. Comics A.D. Bryant and Bo Burnham play comics. Shehnaz Treasury makes an appearance, and it's all very wholesome. Earning an Oscar nomination for Best Original Screenplay is not a joke. Lekin dil se awaaz ya kahani jab nikalti hai to dur tak jaati hai. Isliye is list mein shumar to ho nahi hai The Big Sick at number 2. Favorite scene. There's a wonderful confrontation moment between Kumail and his father, Anupam Kher, where he questions exactly why they moved him to America at such a young age, if they were not gonna let him be an American. And having only watched Kumail Nanjiani in Silicon Valley so far, this scene was a revelation and how. Alright you guys, it's time for number 1 on today's list of the happiest films on the internet. And it is Kumbhalangi Nights. Amazon Prime Video. Farmaish Itti Sari, Hardik Ji, Arpit Barewal, Flower Wild 7, Nagpal Payal on Instagram, Asad Gray, Vineet VKK on Twitter, amongst others. By far one of the best Indian films of 2019, Kumbhalangi Nights is the story of a family of four brothers in the sleepy fishing town of Kumbhalangi in Kochi, Kerala. The brothers have very little money, they fish and do odd jobs to make ends meet, and the house they live in seems like a place which someone had started to build but gave up halfway. The walls are there, the foundations exist, it's just not painted to look aesthetically pleasing. Which is kinda like the relationship the four brothers also share. There's a considerable age gap between the eldest and the youngest. The second oldest is mute, and the third brother is always angry because he's young and he has a sharp brain, but he doesn't get the opportunity to use it. Ab garibi bhi dikhai hai, bhaiyon mein jhagde bhi dikhaye hain. Kumbhalangi Nights happy film kaise ho gayi Sucharita? Kyunki at the soul of it, ye movie bhi hai pyar ke bare mein. Yahan romantic pyar hai, family ka pyar hai, obsessive pyar bhi hai, single parent ka pyar bhi hai. The film also destigmatizes seeking help for mental conditions, live-in relationships, interracial relationships, India's inherent classism, the failings and entrapment of religion, and talks very highly of dignity of labor. Kumbhalangi Nights is pure emotion. It could seem languid, lekin it is not slow. It could seem obvious, but it keeps revealing its secrets. And if you're looking for a happy, feel-good, powerfully moving cinema, this movie by Madhu C. Narayanan, ye list par honi bahut zaruri hai. Special shout out to Fahad Fazil as the twisted Shammi and Shane Nigam as Bobby, jiske dimples mein jaake mera dil kho gaya hai. Kuch nahi ho sakta. Favorite scene. The oldest brother, Saji, under tremendous stress, begins a physical altercation with his youngest brother and the most innocent one, Frankie. As if on cue, the second brother, Bonnie, appears and takes on the oldest Saji to protect the youngest Frankie. It is a scene with so much emotion, because even when Bonnie is angry with Saji, there's a quiet understanding there which is empathetic and loving. Okay, ab is lambe se video ke end mein 5 special mentions also. I'm not going into the details of these films kyunki ye wale reviews mere already online hai, search maar lo. Bareli ki Barfi, Zootopia, Coco, Thor Ragnarok and Hindi Medium. Kuch dinon ke baad happiest films ka part 2 aayega with 5 more movies based on your recommendations. Aur dena chahte hain aap to yahi comment mein dal dijiye, lekin subscribe zarur karna hai, nahi to mere dil ko chot pahunchegi yahan par. Stay safe, bye.
You can all leave now.